Very good evening to you, a sports night. I'm Damien Best. Well, the 2017 CAC Bodybuilding Championships set for Mexico have been cancelled until further notice. This is due to the deadly earthquake that has claimed the lives of over 200 people. A 23-member Barbados team was set to participate in the 45th edition from September 29th to October 2nd. Well, acting president of the local Bodybuilding and Fitness Federation, Dr. Alfred Sparman, told CBC Sports that the athletes and other members of the contingent will be meeting tomorrow to discuss alternative plans. Meantime, Public Relations Officer Ivor Worrell says that they are already looking for other events for the athletes.
We have been looking and exploring the possibility of athletes attending other events within the region. This is just a thought at this point. We have to explore this idea in detail. We will be meeting with the athletes tomorrow to get input from them and to look at it, as I said, in further detail. And at the end of that, we will then inform all and sundry as to what will be happening going forward.
Well, meantime, President Manasseh King is under suspension, allegedly for not complying with instructions from the Anti-Doping Commission. It means King will not be involved in any form of running of the Federation until a hearing. Now, in the meantime, First Vice President Dr. Sparman will oversee the management of the Federation. Well, there were no major surprises during last night's preliminary rounds of the Monarchs of the Court Road Tennis Tournament at the Big Rock Arena on Spring Garden. And one of the title contenders in the women's section, Rachel Smith, defeated Margot Lord 21-14, 21-15, while Sheldon Waldron had to come from behind to defeat Juliet Worrell. There was also keen competition in the mixed doubles.
Busy night of road tennis, mixed doubles on court. Alexander Clark and Sandra Bailey taking on Michael Jean and Estefine Holder closest to the screen. Cautious approach at both ends of the court until Estefine decides to end it all. Clark and Bailey would take the first game, having benefited from some unforced errors. Jean not executing the backhand slice. 17. Bailey and Clark, 21-18 against Jean and Holder. Lethal injection to end the rally. Just what the doctor ordered. Second game as they switch ends. Well, you can see the passion from Bailey searching every avenue for the winner. And gets it.
One serving one.
Then Bailey with a classic through extra cover that left both Jean and Holder clueless. In the end, Clark and Bailey, winners in two straight, 21-18, 21-15. Another mixed doubles clash, Adrian Scott and Asabi Downey versus Jerry Harris and Miranda Manning, closest to the screen. The first game was over in a flash. Too many errors, Harris and Manning surrendering 21-15. Second game up 8-1, Downey and Scott looking to polish off their opponents. Scott produces the goods. Manning and Harris couldn't find a way back from that position, losing the second as well, 12-21. Let's switch our attention now to the singles. Madeline Blunt playing Kiana Holder in the far court. First game, and Blunt has Holder diving already. We're tied at 8-all. Fast forward, tied at 19. Blunt using the back arm, but a switch to forearm, and she's denied by the net.
19.
Blunt, though, will not go away quietly. Locking the score again at 21. Holder long on the return. Eventually, Holder would draw first blood, 23-21, with Blunt committing back-to-back unforced errors. In the second, Kiana, the daughter of number one seed Kim Holder, wasn't taking any chances. Good racket speed. Blunt not silenced at the opposite end. The injection from backcourt, successful. At 10-all, would this go down to the wire? But Holder made sure there was no second guessing, going on to seal it. 21-15 in the second. Another ladies clash, Shireen Ward playing Juliet Worrell. Ward closest to the screen. It's the delicate stuff at an angle. But it was Worrell who brought her A game to start proceedings. The forcing shot. This one went down to the wire, locked at 20 and 22. Ward taking advantage of a favorable bounce. Game point, long rally. Worrell looking comfortable in the forearm. Ward hoping to change the script. That's long, opening game to Worrell. In the second, Ward corrected some of her early mistakes and put more effort into lengthening the rallies and waiting for Worrell to make the mistake. Ward taking the second game at 21-15. Worrell too long. In the third, Ward aggressive, comes inside the court for the winner. Down the stretch as they switch ends, it was Worrell leading 11-10. But under pressure here, Ward goes cross court for the point. But Worrell's chance at victory was halted at 18 as Ward moves on to the next round, taking the matchup 24-22, 15-21, 18-21.
Well, coming up, Gil's hamstring tested and he's looking okay.
Do you live your life out loud? CBC is in search of a millennial aged 19 to 27, female, well-read and articulate, to become the fourth co-host of CBC's groundbreaking evening magazine talk show, Out Loud. Submit a video 2 to 3 minutes in length telling us who you are, what moves you, what do you advocate or stand for. Give us an Out Loud tip or trick. Why should you become a member of the Out Loud team? WhatsApp your video to 243-6110 with the header OL Millennial Search. Deadline for entries, September 30th, 2017.
Coming up this week on Massey United Insurance's Line and Length, another big booking for Kensington Oval, despite some petty bickering between top officials. The West Indies team being scolded for selfish cricket, and a look back at how the World T20 champions made the English shiver in the cold of Chesterley Street. Mass United Insurance's Line and Length, this Sunday on CBC TV 8 at 7:35 p.m.
Thursdays just got beefed up on Morning Barbados. That's right. Now we partner with the BADMC to do something for beef's sake. Learn more about quality Bajan beef, the Carmitas brand, and how you can enjoy it from the farm to your fork. If it's the right cut you're looking for, then for beef's sake, watch Morning Barbados every Thursday from 6:45 a.m. It's the beefiest 10 minutes on TV. Brought to you in association with the BADMC.
Welcome back to Sports Night. West Indies continue to sweat on the fitness of opening batsman Chris Gayle ahead of the third One Day International against England to be played in Bristol on Sunday. The 38-year-old missed the second game of the series at Trent Bridge with a hamstring injury that prompted West Indies to make a late change. But that game ended in a no result after heavy rains lashed the venue. Now West Indies coach Stuart Law revealed that Gayle had undergone a scan and is hopeful to be fit in time for Sunday's encounter. In the meantime, the regional squad remains confident that they will appear in the 2019 World Cup despite missing out on automatic qualification. We hear more in this report.
So the West Indies, two-time world champions and once dominant force in cricket, have missed out on automatic qualification for the 2019 World Cup. A loss to England in the first ODI means they have no chance of making the top 8 teams in the ICC rankings by the September 30 cut-off date. So what now? Are we really going to have a World Cup without the once mighty Windies? Well, they still have a shot at taking one of the two other available spots in what will be a 10-team World Cup. But they will have to go through the ICC World Cup qualifier, a tournament that will be played from March to April next year at a venue that will be decided in the coming months. So who else will be in the qualifier? There'll be a total of 10 teams. West Indies will be joined by the other three lowest ranked sides from the ICC rankings: Afghanistan, Zimbabwe, and Ireland. The rest is a bit complicated, but we'll try to break it down. Basically, six associate teams will make it to the qualifier. These associates play across various divisions. The top-ranked associates have been playing the ICC World Cricket League Championship since 2015. Now, when the tournament ends in December this year, the top four teams will make it to the World Cup qualifier. As of now, those four teams are Netherlands, Papua New Guinea, Scotland, and Hong Kong. But each team still has four more matches left to play, so Kenya and Nepal have decent shots of getting through. Even once the league championship is over, it's not the end of the road for its bottom four teams. They go into another tournament called the 2018 ICC World Cricket League Division 2, where that will join Canada and Oman, who are the top teams from Division 3. It might seem complex, but the idea is that since there are no guaranteed places for associates at the actual World Cup, as many as possible get a chance of at least making the qualifier. The format of the 2018 World Cup qualifier will be decided at a future date.
Very interesting stuff. Well, the Barbados weightlifting team of Romario Ford and Altmar Applewhite both placed eighth in the 77 and 85 kg weight categories respectively in the recently concluded CAC qualifiers in Guatemala. Ford suffered an elbow injury in the process while also battling allergies, but still pulled off a 115 in the snatch and a 160 in the clean and jerk for a total of 275. Ford had to be tended to for his injury, but he'll be fine and ready for his next assignment. Meanwhile, Applewhite registered a 115 in the snatch and a 158 in the clean and jerk, tallying a total of 273. Now, this performance comes after both boys competed in the Commonwealth Games qualifiers in Australia 24 hours prior to this tournament. Applewhite, the smallest in the group, achieved 4 out of 6 attempts, while Ford, who competed in the 77kg B-class group, finished 4th. Both athletes will now be placing their focus on the Phillips and Springer Classic here in Barbados in November. Well, with West Indies 1-0 down in the 5-match ODI series against England, with 3 games remaining, they'll be hoping to level the series when the two sides clash this Sunday. Trevor Parris believes the Windies, even with the return of the experienced players like Chris Gayle and Marlon Samuels, well, they don't stand a chance.
I think England will win this series. I'm saying about probably 3-0. The West Indies problem is the bowling is very, very weak as far as I'm concerned. There's no one to get any person out. I think Darren Bravo, I'm so sorry he's not ready. Matt Fick should be in the squad as well. And you have to look more of telling Samuels goodbye. I don't think Samuels is up to the standard they're looking for. He's not for the future. Need to add another young player in there, like, for instance, a guy like Sunil Ambry. I think he has ability to do very well. You need to do that and move forward and let Samuels go. The only problem I have with Gayle now is that he's the long-term injury. I'm not sure it's going to get any better at all. And to stand up on a 50-over match, he may not last very long at all. He's more better at the 20-over version of the game, not the 50-over at this present time.
Right, in terms of the West Indies squad, you said you're not really keen with the selection process. If you had to select an 11-man squad or 12-man squad to face England, what would your 11 be?
I will still stick with Gayle and Lewis as well. I will love Darren Bravo in the team, which is unfortunate he's not there. I love Shea Hope, very impressed with him. Sunil Ambry is my player looking at as well in that area. Keeper batsman should be a guy called Hamilton, who is an excellent player as far as I'm concerned. And we got Holder as well on the bowlers. You need to bring Gabriel back into the team as well to get people out. Taylor have passed his best as well. He should not be there at all. I still like Ashley Nurse. I think he gives a little bit in terms of the batting depth. And the other player should be Young Joseph.
Well, still to come, bomb testing by North Korea, a worry for some Winter Olympians.
Community Files.
The Samuel Jackman Prescott Memorial Lecture will be held on Thursday, September 28th in the auditorium of the Samuel Jackman Prescott Polytechnic. It will be given by Dr. Ian Marshall, a lecturer at the University of the West Indies School of Continuing Education at the Cavehill campus on the topic, Reconceptualizing Technical and Vocational Education and Training in Barbados and the Caribbean for the 21st Century. Start time is 7 p.m. and all are invited.
We're back! CBC's groundbreaking magazine-style talk show, Out Loud, is back for a second season. Still provocative, no holds barred, and, well, fun. Psst. And by the way, we're looking for a new co-host. So send your inquiries by email to outloud@cbc.bb. Come on, let's get Out Loud for another season. Coming soon to CBC TV 8.
Love Game of Thrones? Win cool collectibles and other branded items with the compliments of MCTV. Like and share the MCTV Barbados page on Facebook and answer the question to win daily. Promotion runs September 18th to 22nd, 2017. You must be an MCTV subscriber in order to win. MCTV, the right choice.
What's your rhythm?
FM, the rhythm of life.
Welcome back. Well, a lone goal by Crystalline Callender was enough to give Kickstart Genesis a 1-0 victory over Technique Football Club in the BFA Women's League last night. Playing at the BFA Willie AstroTurf, Callender broke the deadlock in the 57th minute to give Kickstart the win. CBC's Mark Seal reports.
In this match, we have Kickstart Genesis in the pink up against Technique Football Club. Sloppy defending by Technique in the early minutes gives Crystalline Chandler an early one-on-one opportunity with the keeper. But a soft shot targeted at the upright is easily saved to deny the goal. Kickstart was presented another opportunity moments later, after Chandler received the foul just outside the 18-yard box. But Tiana Bino wasted the free kick, missing the target by a mile. Both teams still in search of that opening goal. And this here, a poor clearance by the Kickstart defender, gives Technique a chance to make it 1-0. But the goalkeeper, Jade Clark, denies any entry. Fast forward to the second half. Kimber Bob Gibson on the offense and working the ball through the midfield, showing she has vision, providing an excellent through ball, which finds the boot of Chandler. And this beats the keeper to the right to give Kickstart the only goal and therefore the victory, defeating Technique 1-0. Mark Seal, CBC Sports.
Well, thanks, Mark. Ever so often, politics adversely affects sports. This time, it's surrounding next year's Winter Olympic Games in South Korea. With the ongoing military show of force by North Korea, there are questions about the safety of athletes. Well, it's that time to tell you what's happening this weekend in sports and cricket. It's the final 2 days of the BCA Elite 5th Series starting at 12 p.m. both days. In basketball, the first round of the First Division playoffs start tomorrow, 6 p.m. at the Garfield Sobers Gymnasium and the BCC Gym. While on Sunday will be the First Division knockout final between Police and Warrens at BCC from 8 p.m. In road tennis, the preliminary rounds of the Monarchs of the Court road tennis tournament continue at the Big Rock Arena on Spring Garden. It's a 7 p.m. start both Saturday and Sunday. In football, there is a triple header on Sunday in the BFA Women's League at the Willie AstroTurf. First game is 3:30 p.m. And will also be the start of the David Thompson Memorial Constituency Council Football Classic. That's on Sunday as well. There's also volleyball action, the Goddard Enterprises League at Oberey. That begins at 3:30 p.m. Oh, that's Sports Night for Friday. I'm Damien Best. Do have a wonderful weekend. Join us again on Monday for another edition of Sports Night.
Watching CBC TV 8 in beautiful Barbados.